This morning we continue in our devotional called Trusting God in Troubled Times. In Daniel 3, 26, 27, starting in the middle of 26, it says, "Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the midst of the fire. The satraps, the prefects, the governors, and the king's high officials gathered around and saw in regard that these men, that the fire had no effect on the bodies of these men, nor was their hair of their head singed, nor were their trousers damaged, nor had the smell of fire even come upon them." I love what it says in verse 27, that when they came out, the fire had no effect on their bodies. These men, nor was the hair of their head singed, nor was their trousers damaged, nor had the smell of fire even come upon them. The only thing that burned up was the very rope that bound them. That's incredible. No matter what humanity tries to do to the church, no matter what laws are passed to prevent the gospel from advancing, no matter how difficult it gets to stand up for God in tough and troubled times, if God desires to loose the chains put on you by society or others, God can still set you free. Because the same power that burned the cords that bound Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is still available to us today. Amen. Aren't you thankful for that? Always remind yourself, even in the midst of your difficult circumstance, in the times of persecution, or whatever is binding you down, that your destiny is in God's hands. It's not in the hands of your enemies or enemy. It's not in your our nation's economy's hands. It's not in your doctor's hands or in any human or temporary hand. It's in God's hand. There might be temporary pains, trials, and difficulties for resolving in your heart to trust and live for God, but remember to focus on the eternal reasons, not the temporary setbacks that you experience today or tomorrow. Today, if you're facing persecution or a difficult circumstance or circumstances that might seem like a fiery furnace, you can rest assured that the Lord Jesus Christ is right there with you in whatever situation you're facing. Because when you resolve in your mind to remain committed to Christ, God will elevate your life and expand your influence to others. In Daniel 3, 28 through 30, it says, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angels and delivered his servants who put their trust in him, violating the king's command and yielding up their bodies so as not to serve or worship any god except their own God. Therefore, I make a decree that any people, nation, or tongue that speaks anything offensive against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be torn limb from limb and their house reduced to a rubbish heap, inasmuch as there is no other way and no other God who is able to deliver in this way." Talk about what happens when you resolve in your mind to remain committed. God elevated and expanded the influence of these three Hebrew men with King Nebuchadnezzar and the nation in which they lived in. Now, I don't know if King Nebuchadnezzar gave his life to the Hebrew God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego right then and there, or got rid of his gods, but he mentions that their God was more powerful than his gods, and he proclaimed that the people of his nation were not allowed to speak against the Hebrews' God. Then the king caused Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to prosper in the province of Babylon. Daniel 3, 28 through 30, even Nebuchadnezzar himself is inspired by their example in verse 28, that a change of heart began in him as a result. In spite of Daniel's example in chapter 2, Nebuchadnezzar was not converted. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's absolute trust in God had a big impact on him. However, his conversion was not complete. But in chapter 4 of Daniel, you can hear about his remarkable testimony of how he eventually came to acknowledge God when he said in Daniel 4:2, "It is my pleasure to tell you about the miraculous signs and wonders that the Most High God has performed for me." By this stage, his attitude had completely changed, and the glory was given all to God in verse 3. He begins by saying, in one sense, he had all he wanted. "I, Nebuchadnezzar, was at home in my palace, content and prosperous," in verse 4. But then one of the main points of the book of Daniel is that God used the inspiration of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and their absolute trust in God to change a king's life. And as a result, it changed a nation. And I believe the Lord can do the same thing in you and his church when we resolve to live and serve and obey God, even if he doesn't come through for us. Join us on Thursday, July 9th for our Devo moment as we look at some things to remember when you resolve to live for Christ in the days of uncertainty that we're living in. God bless you. Love you. Have a great day.